This is Tomo News for Friday, January 26th.
Zombie deer disease in humans? A mysterious neurological disease is laying waste to North American deer, and scientists are worried that humans might be next. Since its discovery in 1967, chronic wasting disease has infected deer populations in 24 U.S. states and Canada, and has also been found in South Korea and Norway. Chronic wasting disease is caused by prions, deformed proteins which accumulate in certain organs. Infected deer can live 2 years before symptoms like weight loss, thick saliva, and behavioral changes manifest. The disease is contagious and typically spreads via the saliva and feces of diseased deer, which can contaminate the environment and infect other animals. Prion diseases are typically limited to certain species, but may evolve to overcome the interspecies barrier and infect new hosts. Mad cow disease is one example, with humans contracting the disease from eating cows that have been infected by prions from sheep. While no humans have been infected by CWD, monkeys in a recent study reportedly contracted the disease after ingesting infected deer meat. Public health officials continue to monitor for any sign of brain-wasting diseases in humans. They have also warned hunters not to consume deer meat without getting it tested, regardless of how healthy the animal looks.
Fitty forgot he had Bitcoin. Now it's worth $8 million. While everyone was going bananas for Bitcoin at the end of last year, 50 Cent apparently had 700 Bitcoins he totally forgot about. Back in 2014, he released Animal Ambition and became the first artist to accept a Bitcoin as payment. From the deal, he received more than 700 Bitcoins. Those coins are now worth 7 to 8 million US dollars. For now. Bitcoin is currently valued at around $11,200, but still remains highly volatile. Not bad from a kid from Southside. I'm so proud of me, 50 Cent wrote on Instagram. At least someone is. Just think of how proud Fitty would have been of himself if he sold when the price was at 20 grand. Looks like Fitty had 21 questions, but Bitcoin wasn't one. South Korea's 10-person military submersible. The South Korean Navy has a submersible that also doubles as a surface vessel. According to Korean naval manufacturer Vogo, the SDV-1000W can be deployed via airdrop from a C-17 or C-130 aircraft. It can carry a crew of 10. On the surface, it can travel at 35 knots or 40 miles per hour via diesel engines and water jet propulsors. While submerged, it can travel at 6 knots or 7 miles per hour using lithium polymer batteries and silent electric motors. Submarine expert H.I. Sutton reports that the vessel functions like a wet sub and that the crew still wear diving gear and receive oxygen from a sizable onboard air system. This lets passengers exit underwater. The vessel can also be landed on a beach.
No going back. As global warming gets progressively worse, some scientists are considering engineering the climate to cool it down, but a new study shows it may do more harm than good. Stratospheric aerosol injection is a form of geoengineering that involves spraying sulfur dioxide into the upper atmosphere to form clouds that reflect solar radiation. Using computer models, a study found that spraying 5 million tons of sulfur dioxide above the equator every year for 50 years could drop surface temperatures by 1 degree Celsius. But if sulfur seeding suddenly stopped, the planet would warm rapidly, with temperatures rising several times faster than the predicted rate. Plant populations would die out, and wildlife, especially amphibians and land animals, wouldn't be able to migrate quickly enough. The loss of just one species could impact an entire ecosystem. It just goes to show how tricky it is to mess with something as unpredictable as climate. So despite all the benefits we think geoengineering might bring, we're probably better off focusing on reducing greenhouse gas emissions.
Sweden's planning a floating hotel. A team of Swedish architects have unveiled plans to construct a floating luxury hotel. The Arctic Bath and Spa Hotel will be placed on the LULE River in the Harads village, northern Sweden. It will be frozen into the river during the winter and float the rest of the year. The hotel's log cabins will also be placed on the river and will freeze or float depending on the time of year. Inhabitat reports the guests may be able to catch the northern lights, also called aurora borealis, from the hotel. And it could potentially be open for business this year.